Hi, Noel again from Rittenhouse. Today, what we're going to do is show you how to repair the Kappa 18 or the Kappa 15. They are both electric-driven pumps, 12 volt. The only difference between them is one has more volume than the other. The Kappa 18 is 4 gallons a minute. The Kappa 15 is 3.2 gallons a minute. Okay, so now we're going to show you how to change the diaphragms, check valves, so on and so forth. If you have torn diaphragms and you've noticed white in the sight glass, you're going to have to remove the pump from the motor. So what it is, 10 millimeter wrench, 4 bolts hold the housing on. Loosen them off. And turn them the rest of the way with your finger if they're easy enough to turn them out. Okay, now that we've removing the last bolt, go ahead and separate the pump from the motor. Just wiggle and pull it apart like so. Now, I always recommend that you mark either one head on a two-lung pump or all heads on a three-lung pump. This would be in two-lung. I would recommend just put a punch mark here and here just so you don't have any problems when you go to put it back together. Take a punch, hammer. And mark it. And when you turn it over like that, this shaft will fall out. Don't worry about it. You put it back in later. Now, you want to take the head off by undoing the 5 bolts on the side. Okay, now that we got the bolts out, take the head off. Inside you'll find the nut holding the diaphragm in place. We'll take the diaphragm out. Now we got the bolt out, take the diaphragm out. We can drop the piston sleeve out. And we'll repeat what we just did to the other side of the pump. Now the reason we're doing both sides at the same time is so that we can take and rinse out any contaminant that's within the oil cavity of the pump. So we would wash these two pieces. We would pour either Varsol or paint thinner through here. Try to make sure that we get all the contaminant oil out. Then we would take a compressor with a blowing tool, blow out any of the excess residue left over, and then we reinstall everything. So as we reinstall it, you always notice that the sleeves always have a hole opposite each other. Make sure that they go straight up and down. As I said in other videos, when it comes to pumps, all it is for is to help evacuate the air out of the pump. Now, if we had to reinstall new diaphragms into the pump, we would order the kit. This kit is kit 630 on the box. This consists of the two diaphragms, four valve O-rings, and the air accumulator diaphragm. Now, when you go to reinstall the diaphragms, take a look at them. There's a ridge on one side, flat on the other. The flat side always goes in, and the ridge should face up. Oh, and the other thing. The return washer itself, it's got a smooth edge and a flat edge. The smooth curved edge goes towards the diaphragm. When we tighten it up, we want to make sure that we don't over-tighten the bolt in the return washer. Once you get it snug and you can't turn it any more easily, give it a little bit of a pry, just so you feel just maybe not even a quarter of a turn. Then we're going to replace our head with the valves. We're going to check the valves before we do return it to the body. It's going to check for is to make sure that the spring is in good working order and to check and see the faceplate of the valve, see if there's any scoring or pitting. If there isn't, you can use the same valve. Now, in that kit, I told you that it came with the four O-rings as well. I recommend that you replace the O-rings when you take it apart with the new ones, just so that you get a good seal. When something's been tight for a while, the O-rings have a tendency to flatten out and they may not seal up properly. You may end up with a leak. So, replace all the seals, O-rings. Then we go ahead, we push that back on, put our bolts back in place. And make sure that you put the tag back on. Once you get them all pulled down about the same tightness, just go back a quarter of a turn on all the bolts. And we're going to do the same for the other side. And now that we've got the other head back on as well, we might as well go ahead and check the air accumulator diaphragm, which you undo these four bolts at the top of your pump. Okay, pull the head off, or the manifold, Well, the diaphragm, check for any cracks. If need be, replace it. Just drop it back in. Replace the manifold. Tighten back up your four bolts. And you're done. Now you have to charge the air chamber. Just take off the little cap here on the Schrader valve. Hit it with your compressor. Now it's supposed to be between 10 and 15% air to PSI that you're spraying at. Easiest way to do this, once you've charged it and got it back in your system, fire it up. Set your regulator to the pressure that you're spraying at. If the return line is bouncing and the gauge is bouncing, just start letting a little bit of air out at a time. Once they have settled down, you're back to where you should be with the air. So then we just reinstall this on our electric motor and we're good to go. We're going to reinstall our pump back on our motor. Like so. Replace all four bolts. Replace your lines. And the oil that goes in this pump is the same as the rest of them, straight 30. Now there is one other little secret I should tell you. When replacing the oil in this particular pump, it's a very small opening here for the oil to travel through. I recommend that you take the sight glass off the front. Just use a pair of pliers or a wrench to pull that off. And that will allow the air to escape as the oil's going in. And once the oil starts running out, put this back on. And then you put your plug back in, and you're good to go. Recommended PSI on these pumps is 70 PSI max. And that includes the Kappa 18 and the Kappa 15. And if you go past that, the amperage will go quite high and you may cause damage to the pump. If you have any other questions on this pump, don't hesitate to call us at Rittenhouse.